It's Tom here. Hello, AHKers. And this is Tab Nation. So today we're going to be talking about tooltips. Tooltips are really cool. If you don't know what they are, they kind of just are almost like GUIs, but they're not GUIs. It's just a way to display text on your screen. You'll see a little bit better here in a minute what I mean. I've done a video where I talk about tooltips, but I'm going to show you how to display multiple. Now, for some odd reason, I don't really know the reasoning behind this. I kind of asked about it. Nobody really seems to have an answer either. But you can display up to 20, as you see right here, 20 tooltips. Don't know why the number maxes out at 20. I guess the developers just were kind of like, nobody's ever going to use over 20, which is probably true. But how hard is it to make it so you could add 100? You know, someone out there, I'm sure, at some point has had a need. But yeah, 20 is the max that you can make. So what we are going to do here is we just got some settings here that we're using, chord mode, tooltip, whatever. And then I'm going to also show you how to put variables in. So we're just calling it variable 1 equals hello and variable 2 equals world. And we're going to use those right away in the first and second one here. So all you do is tooltip, comma, and inside percent signs, we're going to put that variable 1. Same down here, but we're using variable 2. And then these are just your X and Y coordinates. Where do you want them to display on your screen? And then we're just going to name this number 1. So as you see, we're doing 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up to 20. And that's just kind of like its ID, I guess you could say. And then if you want to hard code it, you don't want to use a variable, you just want it in there, you can just write tooltip 3. Now, I know I could use an array for something like this, but more than likely, you're going to want to hard code different things here. Maybe you're playing a video game where you want this to say, you know, health. And maybe this one says, you know, like mana. So you might want to actually like hard code them in and have like them specifically versus using like a loop array. So I know it takes up 20 lines of code, but if you're going to be having very specific things in each one versus being just solely numbered, this is the way to go. So I'm just having them all at the X coordinates of 750. And then I just spread them out by 20, which is about the size that tooltips typically are. That way they kind of all come together. Obviously, you're just going to find the mouse position, which I've done videos on how to find your mouse position to do that. And then we're just going to hit a return here. That way it just stops. We don't need to do any more. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to push, what was it, F1. I should probably run the script too. There we are. I'm going to push F1. And as you see, loaded very quick. We got that hello world right there. We don't have health or mana because I forgot to push save. So let's reload that here real quick so you can see that better. Ah, still forgot to push save. There we go. So as you see, there they are, you know, nice lined up. Now you can see the word health and mana, and that's what we got. You can put spaces in there if you want to keep them kind of blocked in the same length versus how, you know, this one's a little shorter than the word world. You can play around with that by adding spaces or the built-in variable a_space in percent signs and however many you need. Now down here we have F2. So when I press F2, it's going to loop 20 times. Obviously change this 20 to however many you're using. If you're only using 14, just change this to the 14. There's no point of it going beyond that. Not that it's really going to do anything. And all we're doing is tooltip 4 commas a_index, and that's just going to go through and say make tooltip number 1 disappear, next make tooltip 2 disappear, and it's going to go 20 times because that's all we have. And it's just going to do a small sleep between each one. If you want them to disappear slower, increase this number or decrease it if you want it a little bit faster. It's whatever. We're actually going to go ahead and increase it just so you can get a better visual of what's going on. And then we just got a return here just in case I have code down here, which I do. And F3 is just closing out the app completely. You might not want to use this. That's fine. You can get rid of that because you can always right click on the tray icon to get rid of it. So let's go ahead and push F2. And let's relaunch that with the new changes. So F1 brings them up pretty quick. And F2, as you see, I have a 1 second delay. Obviously, change it to whatever you want. We'll let that go. If you haven't subscribed yet, definitely hit that subscribe button. Throwing out usually about 2 videos every week having to do with automation, mostly in AutoHotkeys, but I do branch out into Python, JavaScript, and whatnot. And there we go, it's all done. If you have any questions, definitely let me know in the comments below, and I'd be glad to help expand on this or answer any confusion that you might got. All right, everybody, I'll see you on the next video.